I'm Supervisory Special Agent Dennaris Coleman. I'm 44 years old, was born in Joliet, Illinois. I've been an FBI Special Agent for 17 years. I was inspired to be an FBI agent after a career day in kindergarten. Local cops came, firemen came, military official came, and I knew then I wanted to be in law enforcement. Because I have a strong taste for public service, probably the military, intelligence, firemen. To prepare to become an FBI agent, I knew that through friends I couldn't get in any trouble, so being a teenager growing up, I knew I had to keep my nose clean, stay out of trouble, stay in shape, martial arts, what have you, went to college. The most rewarding part of my job as an agent is the ability to help people. This job won't make you rich, but definitely is very fulfilling on the things you do, the things you see, and the smiles on the face of the people that you help. I learned that you can do anything. You know, personally, I've seen things and been placed and done things I never thought I would have done. And professionally, the Bureau has given me an avenue to help people and use the resources to do the right thing, you know, at the right time in the right place. Probably one of the biggest myths that I've seen as an FBI agent is that there is disdain with local law enforcement or some type of fight between law enforcement and or the CIA, some of our sister agencies. Post 9/11, we all get along very well. We work together very well, and these partnerships is what get us forward. So that is probably the biggest myth I've ever seen perpetrated. One of the biggest myths about being a black or African-American law enforcement official is that you're pigeonholed, that you will be regulated to doing undercover work or regulated to doing surveillance. But in my 17 years with the Bureau, I have worked white-collar crime and a multitude of other investigative stuff. So, no, I think that's the biggest misnomer. Right now, I'm from Joliet, so this is home, and working gangs, working in Chicago, working gangs is a good environment to really dig in deep, so home is really good. But if I can go anywhere, probably Ligat, like somewhere in Spain. If I can give any advice to young African-American males who want to do this, it's one that this place is for everyone. It's all inclusive, and I think now we really understand that we need to mirror the population that we work for. And if there's a young African-American that's interested in this line of work, I'd encourage them to keep your nose clean, keep your foot to the grind, stay in shape, you know, and talk to a person like myself and understand what it is we do and what you're looking to try to do. In an effort to inspire more people, more African-Americans to look into this line of work, I think we have to do a much better job at putting it out there and selling what we do and understanding and community outreach. I think a lot of people have their perception of what the FBI is and what they see on television, which is sometimes accurate, but often, you know, it's not. So I think it's our job, it's incumbent on us to do a lot more community outreach to preach what it is we do. So in an effort to balance social life, you know, family and the job, I always remember the reason why we work, the reason why you have a job and or a career is to provide for yourself and for your family and to be able to do the things you want to do. You have to have a monetary avenue to do these things, and that keeps in perspective. You know, the family doesn't work for the job works so I can take care of my family. And keeping it there makes it easy. The Mediterranean. I've always been interested in Spain, Greece, Italy area. In my spare time, I could be found tinkering in my garage. I like to fix things and all the things that break throughout the week, I generally can fix over the weekend. So that's my spare time. I was currently reading a James Patterson book. I was kind of behind, but I like James Patterson and Dean Kootnz. My musical playlist is pretty much filled up with 70s and 80s R&B. If I can give anyone a quote in my own words that would help to encourage people, just understand the sky is the limit. Take that step. I believe it is important for the FBI to celebrate 100 years of African-American special agents due to our history, due to the, you know, any negative connotation that may have been in the past. It's good for the publicity that we've grown, that we're inclusive, and this is FBI's for everyone. Don't give up. Shoot for the stars. Hope to see you soon.